Throughout our lives, we have countless experiences. Most we quickly forget. But a few stay with us for days, months, or even years and shape our thoughts and actions. Our brain works diligently to record our everyday experiences into memories, creating representations of events that stay with us for short periods of time. These short-term memories are stored in what we can think of as a temporary gallery in our brain before being cleared out for representations of new experiences. Only a small fraction of these representations, those that are most meaningful to us, are then included in a more permanent gallery, our long-term memory, that we can access days or years later. Scientists have long believed that in order to create a lasting memory, a short-term memory of an experience had to be created. The only way for an experience to be included in the permanent gallery was to be moved there from the temporary gallery. But our recent research has turned this idea upside down. Long-term memory can form without short-term memory. When we temporarily turn up the activity of a specific protein called CAMK2, we prevented the short-term memory of an experience in an animal. However, days later, the animal surprisingly had a long-term memory of that experience. This finding is like discovering a secret pathway to the permanent gallery in the brain. We now think there are two parallel paths to memory formation, one for short-term memories and another for long-term memories. This means our brains might be more resilient than we thought. Understanding these separate paths could be key to understanding memory loss in conditions like Alzheimer's. By uncovering how memory is formed in the brain, we are unlocking new possibilities for preserving our minds for years to come.